big things in patch. Feel
I will not go in.
Here we go. We're doing two more.
And I understood and saw that God had not sent
him,
but he had pronounced the prophecy against him because Tobiah and Sanballat had hired him.
Tall.
This prophecy was hired that I should be afraid and act in this way and sin, and so they could give me a bad name in order to talk. Remember Tobiah and Sanballat, O my God, according to these things that they did, and also the prophetess Noadiah, and the rest of the prophets who wanted to make me afraid. So the wall was finished on the 25th day of the month Elul, like 52 days. And when all our enemies heard of it, all the nations around us were afraid and fell greatly in their own esteem, for they perceived that this work had been accomplished with the help of our God. Moreover, in those days, the nobles of Judah sent many letters to Tobiah, and Tobiah's letters came to them. For many in Judah were bound by oath to him, because he was the son-in-law of Shechaniah the son of Aram, and his son Jehohanan had taken the daughter of Meshullam the son of Berechiah as his wife. Also they spoke of his good deeds in my presence and reported my words to him. And Tobiah sent letters to make me afraid. Chapter 7. Now when the wall had been built, and I had set up the doors and the gatekeepers, the singers, and the Levites had been appointed, I gave my brother Benani and Hananiah, the governor of the castle, charge over Jerusalem, for he was a more faithful and God-fearing man than many. And I said to them, let not the gates of Jerusalem be opened until the sun is hot. And while they are still standing guard, let them shut and bar the doors. Appoint guards from among the inhabitants of Jerusalem, some at their guard posts and some in front of their own homes. The city was wide and large, but the people within it were few, and no houses had been rebuilt. Then my God put it into my heart to assemble the nobles and the officials of the people to be enrolled by genealogy. And I found the book of the genealogy of those who came up first, and I found written in it. These were the people of the province who came up out of the captivity of those exiles Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon, had carried into exile. They returned to Jerusalem and Judah, each to his town. The king with Zerubbabel, Jeshua, Nehemiah, Azariah, Rehemiah, Nehemiah, Mordecai, Bilshan, Espira, Bigvai, Diem, Baana. The number of the men of the people of Israel, the sons of Arash, 2,172. The sons of Shephatiah, 372. The sons of Arah, 652. The sons of Pahath Moab, namely the sons of Jeshua and Joab, 2,818. The sons of Elam, 1,254. The sons of Zatu, 845. The sons of Zakai, 760. The sons of Binuah, 648. The sons of Bebai, 628. The sons of Hasgath, 2,322. The sons of Adonikam, 667. The sons of Bichrath, 2,067. The sons of Aden, 655. The sons of Gader, namely of Hezekiah, 98. The sons of Hashem, 328. The sons of Bezai, 324. The sons of Haran, 112. The sons of Gibeon, 95. The men of Bethlehem and Topha, 188. The men of Anathoth, 128. The men of Bethlehem, 42. The men of Kiriath-Jearim, Kephira, and Beera, 743. The men of Ramah and Geba, 621. The men of Mikpes, 122. The men of Bethel and Ai, son of Abel, the son of Asherbiah, son of Mattaniah, son of Micah, of the sons of Asaph, the singers, over the work of the house of God. For there was a command from the king concerning them, and a fixed provision for the singers, as every day required. And Pethahiah, the son of Meshezabel, the son of Zerah, the son of Judah, was at the king's side in all matters concerning the people. And as for the villages with their fields, some of the people of Judah lived in Kiriath Arba and its villages. They did not was for the Levites. The Levites set apart that which was for the son of Aaron. Chapter 13. On that day they read from the book of Moses in the hearing of the people. And in it was found written that no Ammonite or Moabite should ever enter the assembly of God. For they did not meet the people of Israel with bread and water, but hired Balaam against them to curse them. Yet our God turned a curse into a blessing. As soon as the people heard the law, they separated from Israel all those of foreign descent. Now before this, Eliashib the priest was appointed over the chambers of the house of our God, and who was related to Tobiah, prepared for Tobiah a large chamber where they had previously put the grain offering, the frankincense, the vessels, and the tithes of grain, wine, and oil, which were given by commandment to the Levites, singers, and gatekeepers, and the contributions for the priests. While this was taking place, I was not in Jerusalem, for in the 32nd year of Artaxerxes, king of Babylon, I went to the camp. And after some time, I asked leave of the king, and came to Jerusalem, and I then discovered the evil that Elijah had done for Tobiah, preparing for him a chamber in the courts of the house of God. And I was very angry, and I threw all the household furniture of Tobiah out of the chamber. Then I gave orders, and they cleansed the chambers, and I brought back there the vessels of the house of God, with the grain offering and frankincense. I also found out that the portions of the Levites had not been given to them, so that the Levites and the singers who did the work had fled each to his field. Though I confronted the officials and said, "Why is the house of God forsaken?" And I gathered them together and set them to their stations. Then all Judah brought the tithe of the grain, wine, and oil into the storehouse. And I appointed them treasurers over the storehouse, Shelemiah the priest, Zadok the scribe, and Pedaiah of the Levites, and as their assistant, Hanan the son of Zachar, son of Mattaniah, for they were considered reliable, and their duty was to distribute to their brothers. Remember me, O my God, concerning this, and do not wipe out my good deeds that I have done in the house of my God for his service. Remember them, O my God, because they have desecrated the priesthood, the covenant of the priesthood and the Levites. Thus I cleanse them from everything foreign, and I establish the duties of the priests and Levites, each in his work. And I provided for the wood offering at appointed times and for the firstfruits. Remember me, O my God, for Esther, chapter 1. Now in the days of Ahasuerus, he entered Ethiopia over 127 provinces. In those days, when King Ahasuerus sat on his royal throne at Susa, the city, in the third year of his reign, he gave a feast for all his officials and servants. The army of Persia and Media, the nobles and governors of the provinces were before him, while he showed the riches of his royal glory and the splendor and pomp of his greatness for many days, 180 days. And when these days were completed, the king gave for all the people present at Susa, the citadel, both great and small, a feast lasting for 7 days in the court of the garden of the king's palace. There were white cotton curtains and violet hangings fastened with cords of fine linen and purple, to silver rods and marble pillars, and also couches of gold and silver, on a mosaic pavement of porphyry, marble, mother of pearl, and precious stones. Drinks were served in golden vessels, vessels of different kinds, and the royal wine was lavished according to the bounty of the king, and drinking was according to this edict. There is no compulsion. For the king had given orders to all the staff of his palace to do as each man desired. Queen Vashti also gave a feast for the women in the palace that belonged to